Hello?
Hello. You are aware of the fact that Israel is a deeply unpopular country in its region, right? Like Israel is
You
despised.
are really not.
No,
Seriously,
you
not.
no. You
I will, you know what?
truly
I will,
are. I mean,
yeah.
keep in mind it wasn't that long ago that the dominant position of your regional neighbors was just to conquer you and take your territory entirely. They can't do that, and a lot of that is because we propped you up. Israel didn't just spontaneously exist. You didn't get all your money and guns from nowhere. We gave
No, we
them
got
to
them
you.
from the USSR.
You got the idea that the USSR was principally responsible for your defense in the Middle East and not
Pass.
like the British and the United States backing
Pass.
and huh?
We were a communist country, so
No, you weren't a
like it makes
communist
sense.
country. There were communes that
Yes,
existed in the.
well,
No, no,
socialist.
no, 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 no.
What?
There were communes in the territory that is now Israel. Israel was not a
That's
communist
not what I'm
country.
talking about. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about the 30 years of the official leadership by the Israeli Socialist Party.
It was not communist at any point, nor was it socialist.
It was as socialist as Cuba.
Which is not socialist. And also, no, it wasn't. As a country that is very new, that is despised by its neighbors, and that has been built up and defended by arms and armaments and money that the West gave it. I mean, the whole like project of the modern
You
state of Israel, the borders that were carved out.
do understand that that actually basically also describes every other country we ever fought with, right?
I don't.
Now I'm talking to Josh. Do you want to explain to him how American economic aid works? He's sure that pulling this will help the Palestinians. I'm sorry, that is my life partner. They are a former IDF soldier who. Like they're more of an officer that actually did the whole budgeting
Well,
thing.
you're all former IDF soldiers, right? It's mandatory. Let me ask you, what do you suggest we do? Because right now, with the status quo, it seems you just want to kill all of them. And I want to
No.
know how we can keep you from doing that.
That is one thing that I just don't understand. Like, I vaguely understand when it comes from. No, the vast majority of Israelis do not want to kill all Palestinians.
Yeah, of
We don't
course they
want to.
don't say that, but most Germans didn't
No,
say
none
they
of them.
wanted the
I think
Holocaust to happen
no.
either.
You have to understand. This is in Washington.
Wait a second. This is my partner. You may ask them about anything to do with the American budget. Look. But on a general note, do you mind them joining? I'm sorry.
No, it's fine. But right now, the current project with the Palestinians seems to be you take as much land from them as you can in violation of international law, cramming them into a smaller and smaller box. You deprive them of legal rights, of water, of access to outside help or supplies. You try to cut off
Are
their.
you joking me? Sorry, sorry, Vash.
So
I would answer.
the consequence of this is just them being exterminated. Maybe it takes a few generations, but.
The Palestinian population is getting bigger and healthier. If we're exterminating them, we're doing a piss poor job.
Okay, so you
Believe
realize
me.
when you say stuff like that, everyone in the audience is going, "Oh wow, they're lost," because you are worsening their conditions by every like metric Israel has control over. If there are more of them, like people breed in the ghettos, that is not an endorsement of the conditions they're being subjected to. Like there are more people
Don't
living
get
in poor
threatened.
villages in India than there are like in America or than there was before, but that doesn't mean their conditions are better.
Okay, gosh, Gaza is better than LA by every statistical metric.
Okay, well everywhere is better than LA, so that's going to be the case anyway.
Yes.
Listen, what can we
Back.
do to keep you from
Back.
killing them?
A second, please.
Well, but no, but that's what I want. Well, that's what I want the answer to. Like, what can I, as an American, what can I, as America, do to incentivize Israel to not do what you're currently doing to the Palestinian
Oh,
people?
There is actually a few answers. One of them is specifically for you, by the way, as Vash the person. This is my personal answer. I speak only for my ideas. Therefore, they might suck. I will give the microphone to my spouse later. Come visit. Tourism is the lifeblood of this country.
Including the Palestinian side.
Including the Palestinian side. They have vast tourist cities, which are empty because nobody comes to visit because of fears, like unwarranted fears like the ones you propagate.
How would giving Israel tourist money help you not kill the
Palestinian tourist locations? I do it all the time.
Okay.
Almost all the visitors, the religious visitors in Israel, visit the Palestinian cities like Beit Lechem and other Christian spots.
How does this change Israel's policies towards the Palestinian people?
Oh, I will explain. I will explain. Right now, the only economic driver in Palestine, by the way, by Israeli's fault, this is 100% one that I'm willing to give you, that is our fuck up.
Yeah.
The only, terrorism is basically their only economic export. If they have an actual booming industry, A, they are in the position to actually make deals with Israel in terms of money.
They have.
They have, I know, but more.
Okay.
They have more. And second of all, you actually might get a good representation of the people living there.
Okay. So again, the problem here is not, I think that Gaza could use more money. The problem is, you're killing them. So I don't think that them having money from American tourists would keep you from doing that, is the thing.
I actually did the numbers. This is the least violent ethnic conflict in the last 100 years. You can check how many people died due to this conflict per year.
Including stuff like lack of access to medicine, which, by the way, Palestinians have almost free access to Israeli hospitals.
Yes.
I noticed that you two are really skipping around the central point here, which is the policies that Israel engages in to cause these conditions. Like, to be clear here, okay? No statistical increase. No statistical increase in the number of Palestinians or in their life expectancy or whatever else changes the fact that Israel has illegally stripped them of their land, their legal rights, set up checkpoints, prevented them from traveling, taken away water rights, denied them aid, and a wide variety of other things. The conditions for Palestinian people could improve due to a variety of adjacent factors, like better access to medical care, broader aid from like other countries, but that wouldn't change the fact that you guys are killing them. So I don't think doing tourism is going to fix that.
In Israel and another three groups that are funneled by two American Jewish billionaires, that literally at 2003, this is not a conspiracy theory, met together and decided that they want to do the same thing that John Birch Society did in America, only in Israel.
So I don't disagree that the conservative influence is insidious, but I really don't want to like whitewash Israel's behavior here, because Israel isn't just incidentally doing conservative leaning stuff. You've been violating international law for decades and pursuing one of the most egregious open air human rights abuses that like even gets discussed today. So when you laugh at that, it does give me the impression that you're a bit of a psycho.
No, I was just born in the USSR. The things I was brought to believe are normal conditions for a human being would be considered eye-bleeding horrifying to you. Sorry.
Okay, yes. Well, you realize what you're doing here is literally like looking into a concentration camp and saying, oh, well, I was born, you know, my dad used to whip me when I talked back against him. Like,
Palestinians do not live in concentration camps.
They are literally kept. There are checkpoints that prevent them from leaving. Palestinians are denied.
To clarify, there are checkpoints. The checkpoints do not prevent people from leaving.
They absolutely do. There are laws that have been set up when it comes to like identification, and there are pretexts along which people's movement is denied. Palestinians are denied right to return when Israelis are given it, meaning that Palestinians don't have the right to return to their ancestral homeland. Well, Israelis, despite it not even being your ancestral homeland, get to come back on the government's time.
Right to return was not an important part of it.
No, that was just it.
I am a very petty person.
Vash, I am sorry. The limitations and the danger and the economic condition in which the Palestinians are living right now are not an indication of the concentration camps.
Okay, to now, be so I'm sorry. Wait, to be mean, so no, hold no. Wait. Please. No. I won't do with this comparison, okay? The comparison that needs to be made is not between Gaza and Auschwitz. It's between Gaza and Israel, because it's a part of Israel. So the problem is like you're sneering at their conditions and going like, "Hey, it's not that bad." Well, I've seen pictures of Gaza and I've seen pictures of Israel, and I think there's a bit of a difference.
Seriously, none of us are defending Israel but telling you that Gaza is not a concentration camp.
You are continuously defending Gaza.
Under unfair political oppression, they're also not living in a concentration camp. Those two are not actually as exclusive as you try to pretend they are. They are under unfair political oppression. They live in conditions that are way worse than what they can be living in due to the fact that the state of Israel is terrified from an Arab majority within its borders because we have nowhere to go.
Okay, wait, hold on. Stop. Fully legally franchising every person within Gaza would not threaten the Jewish majority in Israel, for one. So that fear is unfounded. For two, everything you're talking about, you are defending it because you're consistently downplaying how bad things are in Gaza. Gaza is like, no, please. You interrupt me constantly, okay? No. Gaza and Israel are lit. Gaza and Israel are literally like, it's different tiers of development as a nation. Gaza, 1 in 10 people in Gaza have access to clean drinking water. They are subject to a massive list of arbitrary legal rules that restrict their movement, deny them rights. It's apartheid. That's the term. It's an apartheid system. It's an apartheid system where their rights and their movement and their access to clean resources are restricted. And this is a system that you are defending. You say it's the fault of American political influence. You say, actually, Israelis don't even want this, even though we damn well know that Israeli citizens do not have generally good attitudes towards Palestinians. You fearmonger over an Arab majority in Israel if Palestinians were fully enfranchised, and suggest that the reason why we don't have full enfranchisement of Palestinians is because of their opinion on right to return, when it is the Israeli government that denies Palestinians the right to return despite them having asked for it for well over half a century, while continuing to give right to return to Jewish people, to impose the false idea that Judaism and Israeli citizenship are in any way connected. Like, you're defending this at every level. You just won't admit you're defending it.
The problem is that we're already barely a majority Jewish state, and even that majority is split between, well, people I wouldn't want to
you
be
are,
next.
You are seriously arguing right now that you have a right to fearmonger over an Arab majority, and as a result of that, you get to keep them disenfranchised in apartheid conditions. Like, if Jews get outvoted, that sucks, dude.
Palestine and Israel kind of coexist basically like in Belgium, and I know it sounds ridiculous to you. I don't know, but the degree of actual separation on a day-to-day level
they're
between
not
like
coexisting, people, it's an apartheid state.
No.
Yes. Yes. The Israeli government sets up the blockades, denies the water rights, denies the political rights, denies the right to return. It's what you call coexisting. You are literally like the South African Dutch gentile who sits on his plantation and says, "Oh, well, The blacks keep to their own neighborhoods, and on most days we get along just fine. Like, you are kicking your feet up and looking at injustice and saying, well, this injustice is peaceful.
Works in a factory with a fairly large, substantial Palestinian workforce.
Now you have black friends. I know. Listen, why do you run from the fact that it's an apartheid state? It objectively is. It meets the definition. It objectively is an apartheid state. No.
No,
it is objectively
that does not in fact
you can have citizens in an apartheid state. It is objectively an apartheid state. It's an inarguable. No, it fits the definition as clearly as anything does. It is as much an apartheid state as the sun rises in the east. It's not something you can argue, but you are arguing it. It's an apartheid state. Israel has control over Palestine.
What?
Israel has control over Palestine.
No, it does not.
Yes, it does. This is why I don't know. I don't know if you consider yourself like a left-leaning or humanitarian individual on the subject.
A part in internal affairs. Yeah. In Palestinian.
Yeah, this is what I mean when I talk about like average Israeli citizen. Like, it's like we're the progressives on this, you know. And this is what you get.